Hey everyone, welcome back to the Precept Biz channel. Today we're going to be doing a remake of Light by Jerome, and we're going to take a look at the verses today and then the drops on Friday. So make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss that, and also hit the bell notification so you can be the first to watch it. But let's jump into the production in FL and see how close we get. So the first element I decided to cover in this song were the drums, which are kind of like war drums or cinematic drums, and they're basically just like a loop playing throughout. But essentially what I've done here is grabbed a loop from Main Stage Volume 1, which you can grab down below, and essentially chopped it up to fit the track perfectly. So right now, obviously, it sounds really gated and just really cut up, but we're going to smooth that out with some effects. And the best way to cover this up is with a reverb. So I've got this one here, which is playing about 55% wet level. And you've just got to make sure you're not using any reverb on the low end, so cut that. And as you'll hear, it kind of gels the whole sound a bit more. So now I've got this EQ, which is shaping the whole sound and getting rid of all the lows below 150 hertz. And then we're adding a bit more high mid sort of treble area. And then finally, we've got some OTT, which is doing some really heavy gain on the top end and compression on the high end. So it sounds a lot crisper, basically. So the next thing I've decided to do is grab a certain part of the drum loop where you hear like a bit of an accent kind of drum, where there's like a bit more top end kind of presence. I've chopped those up and then added those in so you get that smacky sound. So as you can hear, in this part here, we've got like a drum slash tom roll, and this is coming from the same folder, but a different drum loop. So it's just, again, a cinematic drum. So the next sound we're gonna cover is the main re-space, which is in this song. And you can grab this preset from Main Stage Volume 1. It's called Reese Jerome. I've then added another instance of that same preset. But this time we're playing some harmonics an octave up, so it gives it a nice kind of chord effect. And then I've done the same again here, duplicating it but playing an octave up. So I could have done it all on the same synth, but I wanted to adjust the volumes and also adjust the cutoff a bit differently. But this is what this is playing. And so all together so far we have this. And then as you notice here, we've got a different variation of the Reese pattern where we take a different approach at the end where we've got a different note. So speaking of the build, we're now going to move into the snare rolls, which we've got here. These are perfect from Main Stage Volume 1. They're already in that triplet kind of swing, and this is how it sounds on its own. So it opens up as well, which is really nice. So you've got that effect already in there. So as you can see, I've had to chop it and kind of loop it because I wanted to match the original a bit more. And then to get closer to the original, what I've done here is added some channel pitch. So in the timeline, if you're using the wrong stretch mode, it will try and speed up the entire sample, whereas we just want to keep it at the same BPM, but we want to increase the pitch. So this is how it sounds with that pitch effect. So we're going to circle back to the war drums we have at the start, the cinematic drums, and we're going to basically just follow what's in the original, which is every so often these hits. So now it's just a case of looping back and kind of adding crashes here and there and little effects where they're required. So we've got this crash here from Main Stage Volume 1, and this kind of signals the start of the song. So now I've introduced some Endless Smile just to really drown out all the low end and add a lot of reverb to the whole sound overall. Next up, we've got some risers, which I've introduced from Main Stage Volume 1, and this is how they sound. So they're all tonal risers. This is more of like a deep bass growl kind of riser. So this is our build so far. And so obviously we're missing a fill here, which we're gonna go and cover now. This is probably the easiest fill I've ever had to do because it's pretty sure the exact same as what's in the original. But what I've done here is pitched it up 200 cents and it literally sounded the exact same. So now the only thing that's missing is this reverse kick, which helps to kind of swell into the drop with a bit of low end. And this is how it sounds. So there we go, that's the entirety of the production so far on the verses and builds. Let me know what you thought of this one and make sure that you're back here on Friday so you don't miss the drop section. But let's go and take a listen to what we did today.